This is Auslander coming out to you, and today we're going to be playing a little bit of Smallworld 2. Smallworld 2 isn't a sequel to any game like it sounds like. It's actually the first game. It's actually based on a board game called Smallworld, made by Days of Wonder. It's a really cool game. That's super obnoxious and really loud, but let's see here if I go to the thingamajigger. So, yeah, Philip, this guy whose name I can't say. I guess it's Philippe Kiarts. Made a game called Smallworld. It's the best way I can describe it is basically fantasy Risk kind of. Little area you can take over and everything. We'll get into it when we play, but idea is basically like a fantasy style Risk where you have a race class combo and you gotta take over the thing. So I usually play it with a couple people, but I have the physical copy, which I got a long time before this. And why they call it Smallworld, I don't know. It's still based, it's the same base game, but the same expansion with Cursed, Great Games, and Being Not Afraid, which add extra race class combos kind of deal. And there's a whole bunch of other expansions. There's awesome. A whole bunch of different other things going on, which are really cool. I have a couple. There's an underground version, tunnels, a necromancer one, and then there's two other mini expansions as well, like these three. I usually play with them all, and we actually have to play with all the boards together, which lets you have underground, above ground, necromancers, tunnels in between them, all kinds of races. It gets really wild. It's really fun to play with a lot of people. Yeah, one of my favorite games actually played. It's one of the first board games I really shut off for, because the main game's like $40. So basically, you have here's your race. Like, you could be a giant. They conquer regions that buy mountains for less than one. For one less. Oh, you can't actually read Texas and appear apparently. That's really weird. And the images here. And okay, hordes means you can use two of your horde tokens. Okay, so yeah, don't do that. Now I can go down here. Add an extra token to the one above, and I can go down. Ooh, where leprechauns? Where is every night you get strength of odd number things. That can be really nice. Forest Wizards. Go with this one. So now, with Underworld and Amazon, so if anything that has this little icon right here, it's Underworld. I can conquer that at a region. This I can hit that unit. Basically, take this over at basically one less. And with Amazon, you get a bonus of four people every turn, so. I get four bonus Amazons every turn when I get to attack, so I can find a good area to come in at. That gives me a lot right there. That's not good. So we can come in and cost me one less. I'm just conquering stuff. You know, so four Amazons at this stage. And
oh no!
So that last thing I did was the reinforcements. The idea is you can try and conquer one last time, if you only have one token left. And you can roll a dice if you roll the numbers when they say how many you get. And then at the end of my turn, I get 1 point each place I control. The reinforcements basically you roll your dice, and for every one you get, if you have one little block, and you get one reinforcement. Two gets two, three gets three. Fucking giants. Giants suck.
Yeah!
Because these are two are impervious. This one here, you gotta get through eight guys with all the mountain. Oh, he took werewolf leprechauns, which on even turns he gets a minus two to take things over. And at the end of his turn, he puts a.
Oh no!
Now he puts a leprechaun treasure at each one, and if someone else conquers it, we get the treasure. Otherwise, his next turn, he gets whatever the treasure is. Basically, the treasure usually are one. So they get a plus one to every hill, and when you go into decline at the end of your race's time, they get to all get moved
on. Oh no!
And we stack me like a priestess tower of impending doom. You can't take it over. It's kind of cool too. I'm at my Amazons. I think we'll pick up the Giants. We'll pick up this one. And then...
yeah!
Probably wasn't really worth it, but, you know. Telling you're supposed to take a leprechaun. So, leprechaun. Taking over both hill and meadow. Yeah, I'm taking this shit. All day long, I'm taking this shit. So I'll take over that meadow one, and then I'll use this special thing going. Pop! That's not ours. I'm gonna go right there. That's not ours. This is where this is why wizards can be super broken. You can just get extra tokens by doing something like that. Yeah, I didn't do well at all. That's the coconut bot. Not my wife's even coconut bot. Okay, guys, we are actually got another game going on here. So, this is Elder Sign. It's a Lovecraftian Cthulhu mystery clue-like game. So, first thing we got to do is we got to pick out who we're gonna play against. I usually end up playing Yig. You can play thing I can't pronounce. Hastor, or Hastor, I don't know. Azeroth, Cthulhu, Dark Pharaoh, or Aquatha, I don't know. I can't pronounce half this stuff properly, but we'll just play Yig, because Yig's easy, and I can actually win at Yig. So we gotta pick our investigation team. So you have different people you can play as. There's the guard. There's Sister Mary, the guardian angel. She ignores blocked. Yeah. That's pretty cool. She can ignore locked glyphs. I like playing as I like using Daryl. Shrewd Dealer or Bob's pretty cool too. Hunt Joe Diamond's pretty good, and then then Mark Harrigan, I like kind of too, because you can play everything in a different order. Ashcan Pete's actually a little bit better than him. So this will be our next team. Yes, we will proceed to the museum. This idea is like there's museums are different.
Something terrible has begun to awaken within our museum. A something unsatisfied by mere exhibition or human study, writhing with ancient evil and terrible purpose. An entity that must, at all cost, be prevented access to our world. It's likely I will be branded as one unhinged for what I am about to do. From my studies, I am convinced such dangers are not new to the human experience. The very fact that humanity survives to this day, I attribute to our forebears' success in resisting the tormented realities beyond our own. Regrettably, such is not easy study. Among the rarities I have been fortunate enough to uncover, one particular emblem seems significant. A symbol of purported resistive faculty and considerable power. They called it the Elder Sign.
So yeah, yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing here, is playing Elder Sign Omens at this point. And yeah, so the base idea is we're fighting against Yig, who's the father of serpents, and he fills up the thing. So the idea is, like, each room has a Cthulhu-esque theme going on. We have to, our investigators have to go through and complete tasks. They're kind of like clue-ish. There you're going from room to room with investigators trying to figure out how to complete the task by rolling dice. And you, once you complete enough tasks, you can get enough elder signs to either banish him or he'll unleash enough hell on you to take over the world. It's like this one is a bitch. It already has my two special dice because you get six green. You also get, yeah, you get the six green. That's really weird. It doesn't line up there, but you have, yeah, you have six green, a red, and a yellow dice, and those basically are how you do things. Here. Yeah, my mouse is way off, guys, so I do apologize. So we're gonna go. We have to get a. We need to get a scroll, a skull, another scroll, another scroll, and a heart. So that means basically to complete this one, I'm gonna lose one of my health. So it's a good thing I start out with this guy. Let's roll the dice. So what did I get here? I got a scroll. I get a skull now. So I can complete these in any order, thankfully. So, so what's this do? Okay, I can change. Yeah, that doesn't help any. So, no. Not doing that. We'll use this one. We'll do this one first. There we go. And roll again. I didn't get the scroll, so we'll get rid of that. And just roll. Didn't get it, so get rid of the dice. We'll hold on to this one. Hope for a scroll. So now we completed the objective. So we get a whole bunch of cool items. So now I have two chances to use red dice, an extra hold, and two coins. Which coins you can use back at the entryway to buy cool things to help you out, like heal and stuff. No, you don't understand. Ashcan Pete. The awesomest hobo there, but I'm gonna take old Ashcan here and now. He can actually heal up my other guy. This one has a midnight effect. So at midnight, if this one is still out, especially if it happens, that can be bad. I get up next. Talk to the curator. So we need three scrolls, a scroll, and three investigations. So we're going to want to use this to activate the red and yellow dice as well. We're going to need all our dice for this, I think. So since we go to any water, we'll take it. The three. In the snack that's already got it. Now we have one scroll, and that's it. So we'll get rid of a tear. Hold on to a scroll. Scroll again. No scroll. Do I have any clues? No. Okay. So we'll junk it. Skull, we roll again. Only got one. Junk a skull and roll for the last one. Hope I get him. Nope. Now it is impossible. So now we will take. We'll take a penalty now. Yeah. The penalty on this one for not completing is two mental damage. Ow. So mental damage is basically sanity. If you go insane, you die. If you lose all your health, you die. So let's take him up. We're gonna have him open assist because there's someone up here. We can actually hold two dice a turn now. And he actually has a clue as well. So that is helpful. Let's see if I can get this guy. That curator is so creepy. He's like, I'm going to touch you now in ways you never wanted done. Okay. So, fudge all the fudges. So, three scrolls. Yeah, that's a much bigger win than the... Good thing, too. Boop, boop. So now we got an elder sign, some more clues. Not quite sure what that one does. We'll have to look into that. And then some more coins. Sweet. Now for our fourth investigator. Mark Hagen. So this has a terror thing. So basically if I get a terror and don't complete something on this one, bad shit happens. Yes, please. Yes, please. Now, this is the terror one, so. Skull. Okay. pair. That puts a monster on the board, too. Which is not a good thing, but it's not really bad. The technician should be good. So now we have a monster, which is either alter or add to what we have to do. Now, in the meantime, we're going to go to midnight. The Doom track gets plus two. And that's basically if the Doom track progresses all the way to the end, which I believe it needs 10, and we need. Or might not be. Ooh, might not be. Yeah, I think it's 10. And we need 10 Elder Signs to banish him. Becoming Other. So we need 10 Elder Signs. We have to basically get 10 Elder Signs before he gets 10 Doom. That's not too bad looking. But we'll... Let's add the cigarettes and... The Book of Dizan, just to be safe. It can do these in any order. This is a terror affecting one, so we do need to at least meet one of them. I have a 2. The 2s are pretty easy to roll. Let's go with this, the 3, and we'll get rid of that. Investor can count for anything, so we can just go make him a skull. Roll again, and there's our 2. So we have an Elder Sign, a scroll changer, another yellow dice, and 2 more coins. Good job! Let's see what else we got here. Snake person. Ashken Pete. My favorite is hobo. And take on the other monster. I can't be creating a disaster if they get them. Unnatural habitat. Yeah. Ashken Pete needs to smoke to do this shit. Discarding a glyph. Minus one. Oh god, we're gonna die here. Yep. Pete just died. Oh no, we don't get a doom for that shit. So yeah, let's go to this one. Storage closet. Okay. Oh, this one's in order one too. Let's do roll dice. Boom! Cool. Now this is cool. This is gonna open up a special Aether Placer. Even more Cthulhu-y than the normal ones that we can get to, which actually usually almost always get a lot of Elder Signs and crap. So yeah, see, this one's gonna give me a whole lot of cool stuff. It's kind of be a bitch to get into though, but we're gonna do it. I like London, the city of the great race. This is actually like a portal into the Cthulhu world. We can does things. This we'll lock down the scroll just to be safe. So 1, 2, 3, let's hope for a terror. Perfect. Oh, that was really good actually. Now it'll be Daryl's turn. the cool part is, when that happens, there'll be four turns. We're actually going to get four turns. Just my one guy will get to go twice a turn for the first one, then someone else will get to go twice. It'll be kind of weird. Because I think it will. I hope it does that. Does it the right way on this one? What do we get from that? No. We don't want to do that. This one gets me an Elder Sign. I always like to try and keep getting Elder Signs as much as possible just to help try and maintain things. If I have them, I'm going to use them just to make sure I get the... Take a two. So I need a Skull and a Terror later on, so we're going to actually hold on to the Terror. Skull it is. I can't bring my old buddy back to life from that sanity he lost. So what's up? Oh, obviously the Elder Sign. Yeah, I mean, on the Elder Sign, that would have an Elder Sign, wouldn't it? God, I fucking hate when I do stupid shit like that. I guess I can use it for a... Yeah, might as well. Let's just have to use that for this right off the bat. Really? Here's scroll. Yay! We actually got rid of one dude counter too, which is really nice. That actually put us really far ahead of him. That guy's face is so messed up looking. Scroll. Terror. This one's actually hard for a bit. We needed to get eight for the one. And that one's kind of difficult, so it's kind of... Do another... So now we get Daryl again. Okay, so we need six of that. Let's grab this out. Yes. Another portal, but I also got some monsters. Oh, I got a portal. I like portals. Portals are fun. Now we go midnight. Oh no, yeah, Joe's gonna be. Now Joe will go twice this time, like all the way through. Plus one Doom, which isn't bad. I mean, we almost got this guy already down, so let's go to this one. Another diamond! Oh, that looks really cool. I like the jellyfish looking things. The artwork in this is awesome. I almost wish I could have some of these backgrounds. Fall and terror. That's actually not a bad place. That's not good, so we're gonna have to send Mark in to help him out. Mark will clean up your mess, Joe. Mark can do it. If Mark can't do it, nobody can. Send another guy through the random form of the other dimension. Give him. Anything else I can give you? Nope, okay. Here's where I really cheat. Mine. It's not really cheating, I guess. It just that game gives me the answer. I'm just not toying with it. Double Elder Sense took me up to 9. Let's go. Stay away from the windows. Yeah, look at the awesome dead Stegosaurus. He is a Brontosaurus. Let's glue it. Okay, I'm just gonna do them all. That was actually way worse. Let's glue it again. Actually a whole lot better. Better roll perfect. Send Joe in to clean up the mess. Joe kind of needs a hand anyway, so. What's down here? Yeah. Seven. Oh my freaking god. I said the roll of 3. Joe's almost dead. Watch Mark's gonna go and be like, yep, nope, one roll. Let's do this shit. Oh, it's midnight too. Watch your. Nothing. I was like, this dude has like all the freaking items. Yep, that's what I thought. Yeah, this is, yeah. What's this shit? Okay, so 4. Oh, I seem to roll one more skull. There it is. That's not too bad. I guess we'll just do this one. So, actually, fuck. I'm not sure this is the part. It doesn't matter because I just need the rules. I need to roll a freaking skull, man. Okay, I can roll. This thing is, I came in. Doom, yeah. More doom, because I wasn't close enough to fucking up this one. Yeah, I don't want to use a threat. He won't die. The hidden threat. Oh. I think it's rocking it, Joe. That should be game. Yes, tenable! Train driver. Yes, I am carpet my portrait, so that's good. Alright, this is all new stuff. Okay. So we need to take out. They need to choose at least two to keep, so we can go from Washington to Boston, which I don't really like. We could do St. Louis to Denver, and then to Denver to El Paso, which would get us at least 3 weeks. We could probably do one more. I think New York as well, just do a big movie. And if we're doing that, we might as well do this one too. Just to help with that. So we're just gonna go. Hopefully. Now we need to take trains or cars, so we're gonna do yellow. can't. Okay, so we'll grab that now while we can. We have to get this way now. Grab the two greens for now. Dick shoe. Dick, dickity, dick, dick, dick. Dick! To go a different way now. There goes my entire plan right out the goddamn window. So, fuck me. I guess we'll have to save that now. Grab that one, we still can too. What the? So I don't know how we're gonna do this now. There's one thing you can do. One. I'm so screwed up. This right here screwed up my entire plan. That one train. I was so close. And I can't take it either because that dude had to go and be a douche canoe. And I got mine. I guess it.
Yeah.
have four players, so this is the second one.
Thank you.
Too bad. Yeah. So let's go ahead and grab a different game here for a second. We'll go to play some Splendor. I'm gonna have another one that's way bigger than the actual screen. There we go. So another awesome game that I enjoy playing. This is the only game that I've played so far tonight that I don't own a physical copy of as well. So, it's kind of funny, but yeah. I want it imbalanced. This is one I do want to buy a physical copy, and there's a whole lot of other games I'd love to get that aren't. The team works as well as I can some of the other games I enjoy, so I'm probably not going to be talking as much for this one, but right now I'm aiming for this card just because it gives me a ruby every turn now. Or no, I get credit as if I have ruby for all the time, so I always have a ruby now, which is really nice. I mean, that one only, I don't need two rubies to get to that one. He got that one, so now he always has a diamond. My plan was ruined! Not really, I'm just gonna probably switch over and grab. Grab that. Grab that. And we'll grab a diamond while we're at it, just to be safe. So that we can afford this next turn, or this one. Or that one. No, we can afford these two. This fuckhead is hoarding all the damn debt I'm in, so we'll take this to get the other white. And now we won't be getting it. Yeah, it won't be happening. Actually, now next one I could afford. No, I can't, so. We can pick up a diamond for that one. Or. We can afford this one now to have a diamond, and then we can get that one the next turn. Can't do that one next turn, but we can get this one still this turn. That's still there next time, which it probably won't be. Actually, yeah. Ooh, yeah, he could. I need to get people to buy that one, but no one's going to. See, I'm the only person who doesn't have enough to buy shit. No, not him. record that next turn now. I honestly not very good at playing this game, so it's not bad, I guess. It's I not good at this game at all, honestly. And I don't think I have any other board games to play, so let's just go ahead and switch over. I'll put back on the beer. I think how we're gonna end tonight is I'm just gonna talk to the face campers and just thank you all for coming out tonight, watching the stream and checking this out on YouTube when it's uploaded up later on. And thank you guys all. I had a lot of fun playing some different digital board game type games that we have right now. There are a lot of fun ones out there, so just thank everyone, and see you guys all next time. Auslander signing out.